get going here with UMass. Minutemen Dynasty. Still waiting for that progress bar to finish. As always, here through the Elgato Game Capture HD software. A lot of times once this plays back, I'm already talking. Okay, looks like we're going live. I'm gonna make sure I'm not watching my own stream so we don't hopefully have low bandwidth issues today. Had a little issue when we were streaming the other day. I'm also streaming in 720, 60 frames a second here. So hopefully it takes a bit of the load off here for the bandwidth, since we're just talking about Xbox 360 graphics here anyway. Anyway, welcome to the UMass Dynasty, episode 80 here, if you include all the edited videos and then now the live streams that we do from time to time. So today is week 12 of year 6, taking on the 3-6 Kentucky Wildcats. And we are number 5 in the nation with a 7-2 record. Hoping to run that to 8-2 today. See if we can get after it here. Might as well share this out one more time before we start. Live now. Send that out to Twitter. All right, here we go. Let's get this thing fired up. Week 12. Now, you would think a 3-6 team we could take out rather easily, but we played a 1-win Tennessee team last week, and or the last, you know, time we did this, and they gave us everything that we could handle. Much more so than some teams with better records, so let's see how that goes. I think we had kind of a slow start to that game, so we'll hope for a quicker start this time around. And I'm doing what I said I wouldn't do. I'm watching my stream. Stop that. Pause that. Obviously, I want to see your chat, but I don't need to be watching this as I'm playing it. And so far, I'm not seeing any red blinking light for bandwidth issues over there, so that's good. All right.
In the Bluegrass, Kentucky fans not only rabidly passionate about their basketball
you guys
team,
hearing game
but
sound
their
at
football
all?
Program as well. And the Wildcats with a chance at Commonwealth Stadium to score a signature victory today. It's time for ESPN College Football. Ought to be a great one tonight. Brad Nessler
looks like
and
it changed
Kirk
my levels
will have
from
the call.
I said it, but whatever.
We're at Commonwealth Stadium, home of the University of Kentucky football since 1973.
See if I can hear this.
Hi, everybody. I'm Brad Nessler. My partner is Kirk Herbstreit. Aaron Andrews will join us on the sideline. Tonight's matchup is presented by Coke Zero. Real Coke taste, zero calories.
That sounds like a good
enjoy
match.
Everything.
Okay.
We'll be seeing
here we
the
go.
UMass Minutemen and the Wildcats of Kentucky.
How am I doing? I'm doing great. Getting super excited for the release of MLB The Show 16 next Tuesday, Monday night, midnight, whatever you want to call it.
It's got to be exciting for college fans everywhere as we prepare.
Can I do one more video for Joe Broadway before MLB 16? I don't know. It'll just depend on what else I put out between now and then. There definitely will be Billy Bravo's Game 7 of the World Series before 16 comes out.
Real Coke taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything.
But the thing with Broadway is I probably would want to hit Meyer and Skeeter before I do another Broadway, so I don't know. I can't really guarantee if there'd be another one before 16 or not. What game is this? This is NCAA Football 13 on the Xbox 360. This is my long-standing UMass Dynasty. Well, obviously 80 episodes now. So, yeah, I always liked Dynasty better. I like the gameplay better of NCAA 14, but I've always liked the Dynasty better as far as recruiting, especially. I'm ready to send this one off as we're ready to get this game underway. And, you know, since my main Dynasty I ever did in the series is right here, I just continue.
Here's Reese Davis. Reese.
The Gators were ranked 23rd. The victory was solid.
It's not that I'm adverse to giving shout-outs. It's just really hard to do when I'm playing and trying to keep track of what's going on. Oh, that's cool for us, Florida winning there, because we beat them rather handily, and that just makes our strength of schedule better.
This was a tight one to the very end. And for Gibson, he was reading the defense brilliantly, throwing for more than 300 yards.
And for Kentucky, they played the Commodores last week. I don't know about you, but this one feels like it's going to be a great ball game.
Can I start a new series? Are you talking about for baseball? Yeah, I'll definitely have a new road to the show and probably
up the middle
dynasty
for a nice game. Vincent, get 7 yards on the play.
I'm not going to start anything new until the game's out, though, because it would kind of be pointless.
They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. Big
some
opening.
Room for Vincent. Oh,
he makes his
I thought
way
he was going
to
juke in between
42.
Those two guys. There we
did
go.
Did you see how much space
they're going to let him get out in space? We're going to have
front.
Some fun
you
running the football.
Better be thanking his offensive lineman for that.
Oh, this would be awesome if this were on the PC and be able to be modded. I used to love playing the NHL, you know, EA's NHL series on the PC with all the mods where you could, have all the proper
first down, 10 yards to go.
Ads on the boards
on
in each
42.
City and stuff. And they even modded it once to make it college hockey, which was pretty cool. Try to establish our ground game.
He fights forward to about the 43.
So the dynasties that I already have will continue, if nothing else, in live stream form, but I will probably start a new one. I'm anticipating starting a new one.
We've got a second and 9 here.
I probably should get to thinking
ball
about
on the
that
43
stuff
yard line.
Make a short list if it's going to be a vote thing.
At the 48-yard line. Ground on the
tackle at the 48-yard line. Third and 4. Third down. Give me somebody coming across the field here and I'll be good. Yeah, let's go flood.
It's third and 4. Ball on the 48-yard line. This crowd is almost shaking the stadium.
Yeah, everybody wishes we had a next-gen NCAA game. It would be at the top of my wish list. Wish things could get sorted out that could be a reality, but right now, not so much. Oh, get that first down.
Okay, good. At the 48. Here's an update from the studio and Reese Davis.
The Horned Frogs came into the game.
I've done relievers
third.
Before. I've done closers. It's okay. It gets kind of boring and repetitive for me after a while.
Wow.
It's not my favorite. I don't like it as much as being a starting pitcher.
All the way to our game.
But. You know, I've done Red Bull. I've done Curly Fry before. I mean, you know, being a reliever is fine. What do I want?
From the 48-yard line, first down.
I'm going to play up for my guys. Oh, yeah, I like the look of that. Whoa, game freeze. That's not the stream.
To go long and does.
He's gone.
And a great catch down
Harvey,
field.
Touchdown. Yeah, I will never understand
the wide
why this game always would have freezes
on
an offline mode.
He has the speed to stretch the defense, and his
Meadows,
hands are
because of that freeze, never made
game.
A throwing motion. The ball just floated out to Harvey. Awesome. I love it. Oh, the little things you forget about some of these games. Yeah, I agree. The closers do not get enough XP. It gets to be kind of a mess. Oh, that replay, though.
UMass with a 6-point lead.
I love that, though. It's like, I remember that. It's like, why in the world is my game free in an offline?
And the result, 7 points.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the time.
I had to choose between a new NFL 2K game or a new NCAA game.
7-0.
All. Not that I wouldn't want to see competition for Madden, and having two NFL games would, I mean, any sport I always thought was fun. Even when a game was inferior, like 2K baseball.
And they could forget about returning this one.
It was still fun to have a change of pace game, and so I'm all for that. But there's so much in my mind, like I always enjoyed the NCAA games more than Madden.
The offense will
I mean, obviously I played them both and played them both a lot, but there's so much more to do in NCAA. I mean, you know, it's a completely different game when you pick up a team in a different conference and you start playing all brand new teams.
The defensive line got such a good push up front that there was no one on the offense.
I feel like, you know, with so many teams and conferences and whatever to go from, and you know, it would be really nice not even just to get, you know, next gen graphics going, but just to get all the correct conferences in and get the football championship in, which would be awesome.
Second down.
Playoff system. There's a lot of things that would come with having
slides down to the ground.
A new
about 9 yards
this, but,
there on the
you know,
quarterback
yeah.
scramble.
I always advise people don't hold your breath.
And he doesn't like what he sees. He's gonna change the play here.
They're gonna run there.
Hands
get
it to the back.
Oh, nice spin. Oh,
makes
nice
it to the 44.
It's great when a running attack comes through for the first down like this. It makes an offense so much more versatile.
Oh, we're going to the huddle?
They're calling an audible. He's going to try and scramble.
Hit him.
And down he goes at the 49.
Might have to put a spy on him.
That makes it second and two.
Appears that he's changing things up here before the snap. They try the option, left side.
Oh, good. That's
and he carries the ball for a nice game.
What is my so newest series going to be? Well, it'll definitely be my new
road to show.
It's a very
well-executed option play. The blocking was there, and the quarterback made the correct decision to keep it himself and get the first down.
Oh, they'll be gameplay out immediately. What I always do when I get my hands in the game is I cut some raw gameplay clips, you know, an inning or two of a few different matchups. And I like to post all that first, you know, whether it's baseball or whether it's UFC or, you know, WWE, whatever comes out. I like to get some just raw gameplay clips up first because I want people to be able to see the game.
Have
you know, before I start editing
Carolina,
it to my liking and you know, doing all my commentary and stuff, so I always rush you know, quite a bit of gameplay up for people to see, and then I start working
wow,
on my.
Wow, what an upset! I'm not sure anybody would have predicted that one.
Oh,
a man down,
is
and
that
he's in
quarterback
right now.
Oh, that's not good for them.
And this is the 8th play of the drive. Well, as they take a look at that injury on the sideline, let's see what this backup can do at quarterback.
Taking the throw here. No.
He's taken down at about the 33-yard line. Play.
That'll bring up 4th and 1.
They'll call on the field goal unit here
he
for this
the
long field goal attempts.
Quarter.
He gets it up.
That kick is
and it's
not
no good.
Even close.
It lands short. And they come away
wide
empty-handed.
And short.
It's hard for a kicker to stay loose on the sidelines. He isn't running around like these offensive and defensive players. And in conditions like this,
I have
this,
a WWE
2K16
universe.
Only do so much to get
it got kind of backtracked when that one DLC pack came out that screwed everything up. And I know it's back to normal now, but for the most part. But
I think we saw I just haven't put as much time into it since that point.
It kind of derailed me
a bit.
They
took that football and drove the length of the field to put points up on the board. And I think it really started to affect
not only the psyche
of this defense, but maybe even the conditioning where they started to get a little bit fatigued.
And the coach doesn't look very happy after that call.
Well, you only help out the defense when you don't get the playoff in time. You're essentially just giving away
three yardage.
What's
my subscriber goal for this year? Well, I'd definitely like to clear 200,000. Things usually pick up once baseball comes out because I hit it really hard. And if it's anything like the last couple years,
I think I picked up.
I had a couple months in a row where I picked up like 7,000-8,000 in those first 2 months each. See how things go. But as far as goals go, yeah, that would be it. Whoa! That field sailed. Let him wait
really
too far.
Missed a golden opportunity there.
That's what separates a good player from a great player. When you have a chance like that, you need to take advantage of it.
Yeah, how many of you that are in school are in spring break already? I guess I'm not... I haven't thought in those terms yet because my kids aren't yet. And as a matter of fact, when do they start? I don't even think it's
second down, and they've got 15.
I think they go to school Monday,
down.
Tuesday, Wednesday,
ball
next week, and then off
line.
Thursday, Friday.
UMass is up a score.
Yeah. But I should probably be thinking about that as far as when I put content out.
He's looking to pass. He's
going
to go for the home run.
Yeah.
The defender had it and then dropped it.
That was kind of a mess. That makes it third and 15. Got out of my game plan here.
Third down and 15. Ball on the 28. And this stadium is alive.
Get him there, Joe.
Brought down at the 44.
That's good for a gain of 28 yards. That makes it first and 10.
He starts tomorrow.
Right back to
one more day
He's
of school
He's got the skills
left.
To make things happen, and the defense might not be able
break.
To keep up at this moment.
Hmm. Yeah, maybe I should, I usually adjust when I know I'm pretty much in a safe spring break zone. I'll start putting content out earlier in the day,
the 44-yard line.
Kind of on my summer schedule, I guess, where I'm not afraid to drop a video at like 10 in the morning. It's always cool.
Oh, and it's tipped away.
Did a good job jumping that route. I have two Madden 16 career modes. I have Sam Slinger and I have Skeeter Rabbit. Skeeter is a two-sport star now.
From the 44-yard line, second down. Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with five wideouts.
Come up. That's it, maybe. Yes. Yes.
Dangerous.
No.
This one's
come
off.
On.
And he hits him hard at the 39-yard line. That was a dangerous pass.
Well, I counted better for the, to throw that football into coverage like that. You can't expect the receiver to come down with that ball.
I see guys just sliding across the field.
First and 10. Ball on their own 39.
Actually, what that'll probably mean, too, is I can do more live streams like during the middle of the day also. People are on break.
They'll bring him down at the 44-yard line.
There's a lot of times I'll have an inclination to like, hey, you know, it'd be fun to do a noon stream. But then I'm like, yeah, but is anybody home actually watching? So.
He might be playing a cat and mouse game here with the defense.
Pick it. Oh, that's yours. Let's go.
So it's third down now, and they're going to need about four.
Yeah, I know. I'm never going to catch everyone's spring breaks perfect. I'm just kind of trying to get the most overlap and everything. But
makes the catch and gets out of bounds.
It is that time of year.
A quarterback's best friend is a receiver he can count on to catch the ball every time he drops back to pass.
I record with the Elgato HD60. Love it.
Throws and it's incomplete.
Very portable. which is good because I'm always packing up. These days, I'm always packing up my console and my Elgato.
Second down and 10 to go.
Going between my place and my fiance's place. Tell you, best purchase I ever made.
Carter takes it left.
YouTube related is my MacBook, my i7 processor. Fast as heck, portable. Take that and my Elgato with me. As long as I have a console. Console's a little clunky to carry around, but you know, I can record on vacation or record on the road from her place.
That's a great tackle. At the makes 28 me very portable. Line.
Changes the game for me. I used to have to, if I knew I was going to the place for a weekend, I'd have to hurry up, like, kill myself basically doing an overnight, putting all the videos I wanted together for a weekend, rush that stuff up, you know, and go on over to a place and, like, kind of be exhausted. Now I'm just like, nah, I'll work on it while I'm there.
That could be a check with me right there.
My defense
looks to pass.
That drive kind of sucks for us.
Right away.
And I really wish the game would just stop freezing like that. Oh, they didn't give him the touchdown? Wow. Okay.
They line up in the jumbo set.
Oh, you're in Anoka. Sweet.
You may have changed things up here.
Jim, aka Junk Gaming Videos, works in Anoka.
Counter, touchdown.
Carlos there. Put in Johnny Jones. Okay, defensive standard lack thereof. That
just plowed his way into the end zone.
Yeah, but it wasn't all him. The offensive lineman just pancaked the defense on that one.
Here comes the kicker to try to tie this game up. He makes the PAT. So that's an 8-play, 56-yard drive. And it's good for 7 points. We get a tie game at 7-7.
8 plays, 56 yards. All right, let's answer that.
And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He just drills this one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
This is 13. This is NCAA 13. I had a project in mind that I was going to basically use,
the offense team builder, will start at the
and I was going to import
line.
All my rosters as they stood
the quarterback
at the
in the
end
game,
of season five after
five
the national championship,
in the formation.
And I was going to port my team into 14 because I liked UMass's uniform choice is a heck of a lot better. You got all the,
about the
like
37
black jersey
yard
options
yard.
Along with what they got in here. It would have been nice as far as gameplay goes, but I'm I don't know. Once I saw how recruiting was and stuff, I kind of lost the urge to try to do all that. Of course, if I would have done a team builder, that wouldn't have worked anyway, because then I wouldn't have gotten all those uniforms that I would have been moving in there for. I don't know. It was a really big thing
we've
to try to
first and 10,
take
on.
And I think there were just too many drawbacks, so I just continued on in 13.
Nice run up the middle.
That's good for a gain of 4 yards.
We played one. We're even at 7 in this one.
One quarter down.
From their own 41-yard line. Second down.
Get everyone on that other side of the formation. I love the stretch play with a fast running back if I can get the corner.
Gets a block on the corner. Yeah, he's at midfield. And he tackles him hard at the 46.
That's a gain of 13 on the play. First down.
See if we can set him up on a screen pass here, maybe. Oh, that's from the...
from the 46-yard line. That's from the pistol. It's first down.
Like, yeah, I know how to spin. Thank you. I don't know why it keeps popping those up when I'm playing on Heisman, but whatever. Should be on easy that you get the little helper.
Fires
there.
Complete over the middle.
Whatever.
Tackle at the 49.
Something about coming back to a.
That's just a sound play by the defense. They dropped him well short of the line of scrimmage.
Well, they were not fooled by a screen, not in the least.
It's second down now, 14 to go.
Bump and running all on their own 49. Back. Come on.
They come out in a five wide set.
Oh, wait. I don't want to put them in the same.
Whatever. Possibly changing the play here prior to the snap. Meadows.
Game freezing again. And again. Stop it.
Tackle made at about the 49. So it's complete, but they didn't get much there.
Now watch the replay.
Because the defense was just waiting on it, and they attacked. The quarterback should have found somebody else downfield.
Jeez.
Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 36.
I guess we're 2 for 2 on third down.
They'll line up with five wide receivers.
Ah.
He scrambled. He gets rid of this one. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
In a perfect world, he knocks this kick down inside the 10.
Looking like they're coming after it.
He really got a hold of that one.
Get there. Get there. Oh,
a little too much leg into that punt. They'll bring it out to the 20.
Am I ready to see the Wolves lose to Sacramento? Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised. Hey, we gave the champs all they could handle the other night.
They've been like a couple of fighters losing. Feeling each other out so far.
Yeah,
let's
know.
See if they start to open it up a little bit more.
It's
now.
Not about wins and losses for that Wolves team anymore. Well, it never really was this year. See those kids
caught out of the open.
Something special.
And they make the stop right around the 30.
Towns is looking awesome. I don't know. I think Wiggins to me feels like he kind of took a step back this year. But Levine's coming on.
He's changing things up. They keep it on the ground with a tailback.
Jeez.
He's tackled around the 38-yard line. They're changing the play. And he is drilled at the 46-yard line.
Not too thrilled with our pass coverage at this point. Well, we should have had a pick. There was one that should have been a pick, maybe even a pick six.
And he might change Junk the play here before the snap.
He's either at home or on his way home.
He's hit before he can go anywhere.
Well, the gamble worked out in their favor this time.
And he lives like a half hour from here. So.
Looks like he might audible out of that play. Frederick on the run.
Oh.
Dives, and he's down.
Good hit.
That's a gain of 5 on the play. That brings up 2nd and 5.
Trying to confuse the defense here with the audible. Option to the right. Runs right for a nice game.
They've got a solid drive going here. But I know it's not going to mean that much without putting some points up on the board.
Good comes in at quarterback.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 34-yard line. Slings it. And down he goes. Around the 48-yard line. 5, maybe 6 on that screen pass.
I like the play call here. Getting to the receiver on the screen, he had blockers in front, and he turned the play into a nice little game.
He's going to try and scramble.
Really?
Inside the 10. Stop. Touchdown. Big play.
He went right by you. I swear my awareness of my defense just gets worse and worse every week.
That was simply sensational running.
Teams like
and it
Florida,
shows you what kinds of major
decent.
Things can happen when you have a good ground game.
What was that? I missed him so badly.
Kentucky, up 6.
What the heck just happened?
And he tacks on the extra point.
That was really weird. What, they put me on the sideline like I'm doing Road to Glory or something?
You know, the defensive coordinator and the four linebackers who are trying to get everybody
very glitchy game.
They just don't know what's coming next.
I mean, I knew the game had glitches. This is very
they're trying to get an idea based on the personnel that's in the game. Hey, here comes a run. And then here's a play-action pass behind them.
Here we are.
Every time they think it's a pass, the offense seems to be running. Right now, this balanced attack is really causing a lot of confusion for this defense.
They'll start at the 25.
We're running four verts out of this side. Okay. I'm not paying attention to the water.
Going deep. Lays it out there.
Jeez, come on.
And he's level at the 50-yard line. Big play there by the defense. That's their second pick of the half.
Yeah, this offense has to stop making mistakes. These turnovers are putting pressure on their defense to make stops, and it's hard to win when you're always giving the
I dropped it a little bit.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 50.
Get him.
He fires.
No.
Left side. Catches it. He's taken down at about the 19-yard line.
Okay, I know I personally have made some mistakes here, but we are not playing like a number 5 team at all right now. These last 2 weeks have been rough.
Kentucky is up 7. Looks like they're going to change it up here. Good. Gets the ball. And he's taken down.
He finally come up and make a stop. Thank you.
Well, I think it's safe to say the defense had his number on that one. It can be very frustrating for a running back when he's stopped before he even gets going.
Second and 13. Ball on the 21.
How about we make 2 in a row? No, that's way too much to ask. Good Lord.
Kentucky. He's got 2 touchdowns on the ground today.
That was just an excellent individual effort to find the end zone.
Well, then. Pretty disastrous first half. Our second quarter, anyway.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Nice kick, plenty of distance.
Well, they know I want to throw deep, so that's not working.
They threw a pick the last time out. Should be interesting to see what they do this time.
This quarterback can make good passes. He just needs to focus on not forcing the ball to his receivers.
Catches it, and he's looking for more. Brought down at the 33.
What impresses me so much is the guy's vision. He read the coverage perfectly to find his man for good yardage.
Let's just run that to the other side of the field.
and he's hit immediately.
Didn't catch, boy. I'm sure not getting much of the time here.
And that's just great execution on that short pass play.
It was a great read by the quarterback.
Oh, the boot set up, right? Okay, watch. It's play action. So in this game, it probably means I'm going to get sacked, like, immediately. You watch. Oh, boy. Yeah, they were sure fooled. That was set up all right.
Put his defense in alignment and a position to be able to make a play on the football. Everything works perfectly. They just dropped.
Junk and I did set up another fantasy draft there. Season. I want to say I think he took the Browns and I took the Falcons. I don't know. We haven't played any games in it yet, though.
It's second and 10. Ball on the 38-yard line. They'll spread the field with five wide. Looking to throw.
Good job
here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set the throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
Just need to settle down and figure out what in the world I'm actually trying to run here.
Third down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 38. Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with five wideouts.
If you choose not to cover A, I'm cool. I'm down with that.
He's looking for his man, and it falls incomplete.
You know, I keep forgetting this isn't Madden where, like, they actually smartly play a pass and try to box out. And, you know, you can throw one-on-one to a receiver and, you know he's going to make some work for it. This... Yeah.
Patton to punt. He punts it away, and it's a great kick. He's tackled at the 15. How about the coverage there?
Just a great job there by the punt team to get downfield and make the play on the return man before he could get loose.
Okay, like, turnover would be really nice right here.
They did a great job on their last drive, moving the ball down the field for a touchdown. Let's see if they can duplicate that on this drive.
Well, I think this defense has got to do something, because right now the such a good rhythm.
Get him.
Got to do something to try to get him out of it. I would suggest trying to bring more pressure. Try to come up with an
stumbles
exotic
out,
blitz
still
look.
Gets 6 yards.
Try to get him on his heels as opposed to being the aggressor and attacking the defense.
So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first.
This is the starter back now, too, by the way.
They'll bring him down right around the 24-yard line.
Will they run on third and one? Yeah, well, only if it's the quarterback, probably. Well, I don't know. They might run here.
Quick throw out to the receiver. And he's tackled at the 41.
That was a good reaction to the blitzing linebacker. That's what you like to see out of a young quarterback. He just has to ignore the pressure and get the ball out of there on time.
This team ought to be embarrassed right now.
They're calling an audible. Here's a run.
Everything they do is working. The draw right there. Holy crap, my daughter is like fired up out there.
Appears that he's changing things up here before the snap.
There you go. They took a failed screenplay finally to get sack here.
They brought the quarterback down. Nice play.
I'd call a timeout and try to get the ball back, but I'm afraid we can't stop them in second and long, third and long. The way we've been going here.
Defense looking for another sack in the second down and long situation. Drops back to pass.
Yeah, like I said, give it mostly back. Awesome.
Kentucky's a little confused. They use their second timeout.
Defense is, yeah, I don't know if impossible is the word. It's pretty dang tough in this game. When the computer wants to, you know, move the football on you on Heisman, they'll do it. It can be a very frustrating event. Jeez, come on.
He doesn't like what he sees. He's going to change the play here.
Hey!
quickly to the tight end, incomplete.
Love was the intended receiver on the play. That makes it second and 10.
Ooh, he sold your PS4 and got an Xbox. See, as a sports gamer, if I had to pick one, it'd have to be the PS4, and it would be because of the show. I mean, it's really the only sports exclusive. Everything else is pretty much, Everything pretty much else is equal. You know, EA games are on both, and 2K games are on both. So, you know, strictly from a sports standpoint, I think PS4 is the must-have if you have to have one or the other. I have both, so.
From the 23-yard line, first down.
I was always an Xbox guy, too. I bought a PS3 just to be able to play the show series.
Going right to his tailback.
Yeah, I told myself, and okay, cool, it's got a Blu-ray and all that stuff, too. Nah, I bought it because I wanted to play the show.
See here if he really does change the play.
But, you know, if I ever affiliated with one in the past, it was definitely Xbox.
Boy, was he drilled as he let go of that football.
Yeah, he's going to feel that one tomorrow.
I have to say, in this generation, I like them both. I probably like the PS4 slightly better.
They've looked good so far.
It's like they always say the PS4 is the better, probably the better gaming system. And the Xbox One's pretty much the better all-in-one entertainment system.
Back to pass.
If you're going to do your TV on there. Get out of here. Seriously? He can't wrap him up and they get a first down. Awesome. Just freaking awesome. And he's open in the end zone. Get the hell out of here.
An excellent pass to the wideout for six.
That wide receiver had his eyes on the end zone the second he caught the ball.
Yeah, the PS4 will be loud. My PS4 has never been as loud as my PS3 used to be. I mean, it sounded like a vacuum cleaner or a rocket about to launch. And my PS4 will make noises like that too. One thing I don't like, and it's probably related to that. I mean, maybe it's the big external power brick that keeps the Xbox from making that noise like that. But that's the thing. It's like I don't like carrying around the big external brick. And then I've had so many Xbox 360 bricks crap out on me and had to replace them that it's like, ugh, I'm just leery of them. But I've always liked that the PS4 just has the, like a standard plug. Well. This didn't go well.
At the 25-yard line. They come out on an empty
I think
backfield.
This will pretty much kill any opportunity we have of winning the national title unless we come back and win this thing somehow.
Drops to throw on first down. Deep ball.
But you know what?
And he makes a catch to the 20.
Gotta take advantage of this glitch whenever you can, right? For whatever reason, especially with just seconds on the clock, you can pretty much always throw deep on a team. In NCAA 13.
It was a pretty smart move, too.
You've never seen me get frustrated? Oh, it's happened before. It hasn't happened in a while. Sometimes I get... If I'm frustrated enough and it's something I've edited and put together, I... Back in the days, back when B Wildcat was around here all the time, I remember putting out a... It was one of these games. It might have even been an NCAA game. I put like a frustration meter on there, and with each and every play, like the frustration meter just kept getting higher and higher. I can't remember what video that was for or what series that was for.
So at the end of the half,
but it was kind of funny.
The Wildcats lead 28-14.
I don't think it was the coach getting tossed in the air, but yeah. Yeah, the 500 gig hard drive's a pain once in a while, but like, you know what I usually do is uninstall games, you know, like when when the show comes out here, and once I've ported all my players, there'll be no real reason to go back to 15. So I'll uninstall it, and it can always reinstall. And he got all. Although I've gotten to the point where a lot of my games are digital downloads now, but I'm assuming it just allows you, if you bought it before, to download it again if in worst case scenario.
Thanks, Brad. The coaching staff couldn't be more excited about the way those guys came out and showed everyone.
The drunk video playing in the Hollywood Bowl. Oh my goodness. You mean Smoke a Bowl Stadium? Was that for Vikings franchise? Or no, you're talking about the Holiday Bowl, the Land O'Lakes video. Yep, that wasn't the frustration meter one, but hello. Hey Coleman, how's it going? Okay, you can have an orange if that's what you want. They're in there, just grab one.
He may have changed things up here.
A defensive stop on this drive would be a good idea. Very good idea.
You can't take sacks like that as a quarterback. You just can't. If you can't find a receiver, get out of the pocket and throw the ball away.
From their own 23. That is what I named my stadium, right? When I moved the Vikings to LA, wasn't it Smoke a Bowl Stadium? Pretty sure it was. I think it was sponsored by Snoop Dogg.
Looks to pass.
Or in honor of them or whatever. Okay. Them breaking tackles is getting really, really annoying. The stream will go until this game is over and then probably my recruiting.
Houston back deep to return. And this one is a beauty.
Feels like ages since we made a defensive stop, or have we even, Houston in this game? Certainly not in the last four drives until that one. Okay, I think it's too early to just completely abandon the run game here since we had some success with it.
Inside handoff. He's tackled at the 45-yard line. Gain
of 14 yards. Attaboy. That makes it first and 10. Can he stop it? Nope. Let's go over this way.
Hands it to the back. And he carries the ball for a nice gain. Vincent gets 7 yards on the play.
That'll bring up second and 3.
Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down.
We need this. Let's go. Nah, they're catching on.
Down he goes at about the 47-yard line. That makes it
3rd and 3. They're catching on a little bit.
They need about 3 yards to get the first down here on third down. Third down and short. Got to be hard to hear for the offense. This crowd is deafening.
No, don't stop. Get up.
He's taken down.
We're going for this. Forget that. Hate that when his momentum starts going backwards like that. I can't even remember who my fullback is, but you know what?
So they're going to go for it here.
This is always money in Madden. Better
this is
be money
a very
here too.
Questionable play call here. I'm not sure I agree with it.
There we
he
go.
He gets out to about the 42-yard line. Let's throw it out to Reese now for a studio update.
Deep connections between Auburn and Georgia, and the Tigers and Dogs square off in the Deep South's oldest rivalry. One word to describe this rivalry: nasty. Auburn leads it 3-0.
Ooh, there's a barn burner. 3-0.
All right, thanks, Reese. Back to the live action here. First and 10, ball on the 42.
No, what the heck? Oh, I hate this so much about that game. There's no way that guy makes that interception. Freaking Superman. I'm throwing 10 yards behind him. Super linebackers and super defenders in this game. What I hated the most about it, and I completely remember now.
It's first and 10. Ball on their 24.
Pisses me off so much. See, there's been so many good things that you don't even realize these days now. In play, oh, God, they sucked me right into it. They sucked me right into it. In playing Madden, like if you play this year's Madden, like there's just so many smart things that you can do as far as where you can throw the ball, how you throw the ball. You know, a loft pass, a zip pass. And then, you know, on top of that, then you've got defenders who are receivers, like I said. Like, I love in a case like where I'm playing with Sam Slinger and I've got big tight ends like Zach Ertz and stuff. You get them locked one-on-one and they've got like a size mismatch and it's over. It's like they're going to box out and they'll catch it just about every time. You know, they make smart plays. And then you get into this where you get cheated by the defense. Yeah.
That's a loss of about five. Well, that's just a sound play by the defense. They dropped him well short of the line of scrimmage.
Screenplays suck on Madden.
Third down, and they need.
Oh, you talk about it like trying to defend them? Because I can get them going sometimes with Adrian Peterson and so. That's just such a cheap turnover. I'm sorry.
He's looking to pass. Open field,
I mean, somebody didn't
so
break
a
tackle
yards,
for once.
But they're nowhere near picking up the first down.
Well, it was third down and long. They had a long way to go. I think that was
Let's
more
do
of a
this
safe
return.
Call.
He
the
kicked
last
it short
thing this
last time.
Offense wants to do is take a shot downfield and cause some kind of turnover.
They'll line it up for a very
There's been
long
big pivotal
overtime.
Moments in this UMass series where I had kick return off a field goal. I think I beat
this.
Auburn that way. Go!
Down at the 43-yard line, so the freshman kicker isn't able to put it through.
Oh, trying to defend them, yeah, most definitely.
On the sidelines, he isn't running around like these offensive and defensive players. And in conditions like this, the stationary bike can only do so much to get your body to heat up.
Playing off on me.
43-yard line, first down. Caught open field. They'll bring him down at the 47-yard line.
Great touch by the quarterback. Floating that one right into his hands. That takes some skill.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 47-yard line.
If my defense is actually going to stop them, we got time here. I'm almost afraid to throw the ball. I'm afraid they're going to hose me.
From the 43-yard line, it's second down.
I don't know that I agree that Madden plays like shit. I like how it plays this year. I mean, are there always going to be flaws? I mean, I feel like we've gotten to the point where, like, we're almost... You know, we want everything to be perfect, and when not, we just say, oh, this sucks. And, I mean, I guess it's always been that way to an extent. Or I think, you know, it's like the popular thing in social media to just kind of crap on games. And I realize there's things I would change too, but, like, in playing this, I realize all the stuff that I like about Madden, about, like, trying to run an offense that I can't do here that frustrates me. So... I mean, I guess to see it both ways. I would love to see
Kirk, that was a nice grab there.
NCAA with more like the, you know, obviously the graphics, right. But also the player control that you're getting Madden these days. I think it'd just be a blast. Could I please do a Red Sox franchise? Well, I mean, you got to know with me, a Red Sox franchise is always on the... It's always on my mind. It's always an option for me because, you know, I've done it in the past. It's obviously
so an empty backfield with five wide receivers.
One of my two favorite teams.
arguably my favorite team.
I give him a... I knew right when I threw that he's going to pick it. Oh, he fumbled? These guys are just...
It's a good job of securing the fumble and avoiding a turnover.
That one's more my fault, though. He didn't really do anything too crazy.
Out of the way, I just...
They better give us that fumble. Don't review that. Come on!
It's first down. They're going to get this.
So the question here is whether or not his knee hit the ground before the ball came out. Well, after seeing the replay, it was apparent that his knee was down before he lost the ball.
Yep. Those guys in the booth aren't perfect, but they got it right this time.
Of course
time.
He gave up the football. How is my bracket? You know, honestly, I haven't even paid attention. I had Michigan State winning it all, so that pretty much tells you how my bracket is.
That's
pretty much when I stopped. I'm beginning to think if we don't get like a pick six here soon. Oh, what? He's going down and he warps back up to standing? Come on now. And why are they going hurry up? They should be killing clock. I know that's pretty much what the computer does in this game.
Looks like he might audible out of that.
90% of teams play this way.
Where's 31 going? I guess he's covering that guy in the flat, but what?
I mean, I'm just going to say now, we don't deserve to win this game the way we're playing, but we're certainly not getting breaks either. And this defensive awareness is just crap.
So they pick up quite a few yards on that play, Kirk.
Boy, that was an excellent route, and he did a great job of holding on to the football.
One more quarter to play, and now they're just trying to hang on.
Into the fourth quarter, down two scores. Kentucky. Unable to really stop this team. If they throw here, I'm screwed. Oh, unless he does that. The dude just calms down and
it's third down and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks.
Lobs him the ball over there. I'm really getting sick of the on-screen stuff popping up. It's like it honestly treats us like I haven't played the game before or something. Pick. You gotta pick that. Let's go.
I'm not sure the quarterback saw him when he was getting ready to pass because he stuck his paw right in the passing lane.
Browning wants to pin these guys deep, and you got to think he'll be looking coffin corner on this one. He really got a hold of that one. So this one goes into the end zone.
Honestly, I don't know if I just try to hit a screen at this point. It's been a night try to run and hope I can break one right off tackle or something. Yeah, you're seeing all my picks here. Football. That's awesome. Junk Johnson does not approve.
It's been a performance filled with flaws, but when you're on the road, you can't expect perfection.
Three picks, Meadows. Any chance they bump and run my two wides on stick and
they'll
nod?
Go to work at the 20.
Please? Ooh, they are. They're going to. Okay. Took the safety on the left side of the field. It's the beast. Let's try to go to Houston on the right, maybe. Oh, game frozen. Please throw the ball at some point. Awesome. Don't fall down catching this. You fell down catching it. I hate that animation. It makes sense if the ball, you really got to lunge for it 5 yards beyond you. But, I mean, I hit him in stride, did I not? See, now I'm going to throw a pick down here. You watch. because that's what I do in the red zone. I'm known for it. Give me.
So after the big pass play, we've got a first down. It's caught. First down.
Find a way to pick that on me. I'm going to be pissed.
That makes it first and 10. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 10.
When will Skeeter be uploaded? You talking football or baseball? I don't know. There should be Skeeter in some form pretty soon. I think he's due for a football video before baseball, though, if I'm not mistaken. Not that everything has to go in order, but try to kind of keep some semblance of what I've put out before something else. It's time to go to
second and six
the money play, that tight end
six
spot.
6 yards to the end zone.
Let's see if it works out for me down here. Throw me underneath.
Looks
there we
to
go.
The end zone. Caught, touchdown.
All right.
He's thrown his third touchdown pass of the game. He's been
defense has got to stop him again.
Making plays. That is a great touchdown.
The extra point. The Minutemen, they line up to kick this one away.
Johnson sets a return.
Sends it sailing downfield.
Patton, Mr. Everything when it comes to kicking. Punter, kicker.
Forget about returning this one.
He's the best rated at both, so he does both.
This is
I feel like taking a chance and doing a double
right
safety
here,
blitz here.
So tight, your best players have to step it up on both sides.
It's
of the
risky.
Kentucky
it's very risky.
Up seven.
And they run the football. They and you know
right
what?
Side.
Screw this guy. That should have been the perfect call for that. Come on. Doing it again. I don't even care. They're going to cheat me. I might as well just blitz.
He might be playing a cat and mouse game here with
he sees it. Darn it. Pick. Pick that. Let's go. Two good things there. Incomplete pass and a stop the clock.
From their own 38-yard line. Second down.
How many videos do I make in advance of uploading them? If I'm on a really good roll, I'll be a day ahead. I've always wanted my goal, my personal goal for myself, which clearly I don't take seriously enough because I've never actually gotten to the point. But you know, unless I'm going on vacation or you know some special circumstance, my goal has always been to like have like a 2-day cushion and just kind of maintain that at all times. And screw this defense.
He gets to about the 34-yard line.
They've got a solid drive going here. No, it's not going to mean that much without putting.
So generally, okay, so a typical day, I'm going to get another guy hurt. Oh, yeah, go sit down for a while. You're pissing me off. It's been hard to tackle all game. My typical day would be, like, I usually record a couple things. If all goes well, I record a couple things the night before. So then I start a day. Wow, this guy, it doesn't matter. You know, plug anyone in here. They're just going to gouge us with the run. This is awesome. Even when I'm blitzing two safeties at the middle, really. So I'll record a couple of things. You know, I'll have the gameplay ready, and then I'll wake up in the morning and I'll start editing those two. So then, you know, hopefully what'll happen is I have two videos basically ready to go by noonish, and have those uploading so that I can have my typical
Kentucky.
Times for things going live at like 2 and 3:30 or 2 and 4
is pretty much what I shoot for on like when I on a day when I know everyone's at school.
Now that changes a bit when it's summertime or spring break. So
then I always hope to have something done, recorded, uploaded before, you know, like the day before, so I can have that up at like 10 o'clock. But yeah, if I were to, you know, in a perfect world, my goal would be to have my content done about 2 days ahead of time. Have a 2 day cushion to work on. Because it gets really stressful when you know you just... Oh, you are not getting away from that. Ugh. It gets really stressful when you know that you're recording, editing, uploading, you know, commentating, doing all that for the same day's video. Because then I've run into times where, you know, YouTube uploading isn't working right. And all of a sudden things, you know... You get a thing saying it's going to be 300 minutes for your video to upload when it should only take 20.
They're going to try a long field
goal, glitches in the system that you're at the mercy of then. So that's why I always would like to have that cushion. Now, does it happen? Usually
the
not. Miss it. And miss it. Off the bar. There we go. Let's needed that.
Reese Davis in the studio.
The Hurricanes arrive at today's game, number 2 in the nation. And for Miami... They've won 10 straight.
But that's kind of my thinking. It's you know, behind the scenes on that. I strive for being ahead because you just never really know what's going to come up. Like today, my son had a doctor's appointment he needed to be at. I needed to pick him up.
Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away.
It isn't snowing here, but like the southern half of the Twin Cities metro is getting a bunch of snow. I've kind of been in and out of like the edge of it today, driving around. Like stuff like that slowing down. I had to get my daughter after his appointment, then pick him up, finally get home. And so like my second video never even got done today. And I'm like, that's why I said, well, you know what? Maybe I should just do a live stream. Instead of, you know, rushing out that edit and the commentary and then the upload. I'm like, you know what? That one's already ready to go. Mine is commentary for tomorrow. If I choose to do that. So that's why I figured live stream right now. That goes up as a second video when it's done later on. I get to interact with you guys, so. And it's not like, you know, if all things being equal, I would do, like, you know, if I could set my perfect workload for a day, be 2 edited videos and 1 live stream, you know, probably roughly an hour live stream a day. Now that never, you know, consistently happens that way because there's a lot of other stuff going on, but that would be my perfect model in my head. So, yeah.
It's first and 10.
Ball and sometimes, though, it's really easy to just kind of get in that mode of, like, okay, record, edit, upload, repeat. That, like, sometimes, like, you know, I've got to kind of remind myself, you know, you really should stop and do a live stream. Just change it up a little bit. Like, it's not that I don't want to, but I just get, you know, so involved in everything else I'm doing.
And I kind of get off the track, and then I tend to, like, when I do remember, I'm like, live stream, live stream, live stream. I, like, throw a bunch in there at once.
And I probably should just be, like, you know, less sporadic
and do them more regularly, and then,
you know, because then I get these points where I do a ton, and they're like, whoa, what's with all the live streams? Because it is a lot of fun to do.
So it's second down and about 2 yards to go.
I feel like...
They spread the field in the gun with 5 wide receivers.
I'm afraid of throwing the pick that's going to seal things.
He heaves it deep.
Oh, he's wide open. Come on, you overshot him.
They just miscommunicated. It looked like the wide receiver was going in one direction.
Yeah, there'll definitely be streams for MLB release week. There will be a new road to the show.
I haven't named them yet or completely decided on what his position's going to be. So I got to kind of figure that stuff out in my head this week.
There should be a new dynasty as well. There should be some Diamond Dynasty. I'm going to mess around with that with the new player friend stuff. So I definitely see Diamond Dynasty being a live stream thing that I'll probably do quite a bit.
That's what I envision anyway. But yeah, there'll be a ton of gameplay, just like raw gameplay off right off the bat.
They've done a great job. I'll throw a bunch of that with the underneath pass
out there.
The quarterback isn't forcing the ball, and you can see how effective he is.
First down, 10 to
like
go.
I do every year all on the 42 with a new game, line. Whether it's baseball or Madden. A little more or, than 2 minutes to go in the fourth quarter. Pretty much anything. Okay, dude. Get yourself open. Get yourself open. He's not open, and I'm going down. Had no chance there.
So the sack makes this a second and
long.
That's
like a jailbreak. Name him Darrell McCoy. If they said that, I'd consider it. Oh, I thought for the life of me that was going to get picked. I'm like, he's not clearing the defense like I wanted him to here. He gets pushed off. And then he's, wow. Of all the passes I've thrown, how do I complete that one? Seriously. You got linebackers doing like 10-yard backward vertical leaps to pick passes off, and that's not going to get picked off? Interesting.
Short yardage situation here. It's third and one.
Okay, we need this first down, and we got to start thinking about conserving time here. And he backs his way into it. Oh, I don't like this set.
They come out in a goal line set.
I don't like this set at all. Hurry up, guys. Come on, no. Oh, what am I doing? Yeah, don't go there. Yeah, I just didn't like that play. I probably should have just called timeout.
Seeing the ball and coming up and simply batting the ball away.
More or less wasted a down there.
And this is the 10th play of the drive. They'll line up with five wide receivers.
Yeah, you blitzing me. Got a man, watch out here. Yeah. See that
They'll
coming.
Bring him down at about the 15-yard line.
Davis makes the tackle at the 15-yard line.
First down. Could see those linebackers cheating up. Just flip the play, go the other way. See what they're gonna bring. Another blitz.
Get to that quickly.
Okay,
and he's tackled at the 8-yard line. How about that play?
That's a good pickup there. He just dropped back and delivered a nice throw.
I don't want to rush too many of these plays. What do we got?
They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down.
Just give me like a second or two to throw, guys. Oh, he's with him. Losing. Okay, first down.
Wesley picks up around 5 yards
didn't
with that
see
catch.
A stat line
that's
there.
Just
I called
great
a hurry
execution
up.
On that short pass play.
When you've got a quarterback making throws that quickly, the defense
right
doesn't have a lot of time to react to the play. Everybody bunched up tight defensively.
I'm like, I thought he was going to keep going towards the sideline. I'm like, don't stay in that spot where the linebackers can get us. All right, I think I'm going back to shotgun. That was kind of freaking me out.
From the 3-yard line, second down.
Play works better when you got a little more space anyway. Oh, too many guys over here. Get it to him. What? No! Come on! What? Oh. No freaking way. They dropped that guy back in coverage. And I only got 2 timeouts. I'm not going to claim all of them as my fault, but four interceptions is just not going to get you a win. And that's just, that sums up the game right there. Nice tackling, idiots.
To the 20. Touchdown, Kentucky. Well, that touchdown should just about ice this one.
That was one frustrating trolling game right there. Hardcore. Why not run it in? I don't know, because I don't usually have much luck from there running it in on those situations. I tend to stuff it. Got the clock as an issue. But yeah, easy to say afterwards.
Why not run it in? I know.
Kentucky lines up for the kickoff. And he got all.
I just pulled the Seahawks. Yeah, pretty much.
Let's see what they can do on offense as they take possession after the return.
Not looking so good for the offense. At this point, all they can do is put the ball in the air and hope.
The offense will take over at the 25-yard line.
I don't know why they insist on playing bump and running these guys. They're probably going to get beat. And that shows the guy anyway, and he pass off. Awesome.
He really fought to
there goes my title hopes. Yeah, they were pretty slim with already two losses anyway, but yep. Ambush game. Should have known it from last week when Tennessee played us so hard and we escaped that. I didn't feel like I was overlooking these guys, but kind of got out of that rhythm early and never really recovered.
He wants it all going long. Tackle made at the 49. That last
that'd be NCAA's version of the aggressive catch right there. Dang.
I like the way he's throwing the football today, showing a lot of poise in the pocket.
Yeah, it sure has been easy to compliment this kid today. He's had a great game. Now it's first and 10 with a defense trying to regroup after giving up the big pass. He's changing things up. Going deep.
Man, I don't know if this quarterback misread the defense or just made a poor decision, but that wasn't a pass.
Disappointing, guys. Disappointing.
From the 49-yard line, it's second down. And they'll try one.
Students about to rush the field at Cowboys Stadium.
But that's about all they're going to
yeah.
get right here. He goes downtown.
And you're going to troll me by giving me a touchdown on the last play. Sounds about right. Too little, too late. Too many mistakes. Sinks UMass today here. How do you lose to an unranked team? That's what makes college football great, man. Not for the team that's the ranked team that blows it, but
he splits the uprights with the extra point.
I said we had to work hard just to get past Tennessee last week, and they only had one win, and now
so this one's final.
This.
Very well played by both teams today. Kentucky 35, UMass 20.
Yeah, the crowd did a whiteout. Yeah. Well, that's going to drop us in the polls.
Up, Kirk, what final thoughts do you want to share?
I'm practically speechless.
Maybe we'll be going to the
just
Holiday Bowl, and I can get drunk again.
What a moment for these guys to pull off this shocker! Kentucky got these guys into a dogfight, and in the end, they just wanted it more. They made the plays they weren't supposed to make, and
play another. Yeah, I usually keep these. Well, I do keep these streams to one game because I they're still in episode form. They're just live streams, so
I'll do my recruiting, but
I'll save the next game for the next episode, the next time around.
Here's a look at our player of the game. EA Sports will donate.
Plus, if this thing goes like 3 hours, I got a couple problems. Then my kids don't get to bed on a school night, and I got a 3-hour video processing that may not ever go up. Hey, Junk's Online, guys. Everybody? Misfit 1413? Oh, yeah. There's our non-throw for the touchdown. Looks awesome in the highlights. Holy cow, my daughter sounds like she is like on straight like sugar rush out there. Holy cow. I don't know what she's got going, but dang. Maybe I can get in the Chick-fil-A bowl.
That was my number one game rank game. I think I played better than that. I think I've been involved in better than that. Whatever. Tell John Keeler he needs to learn how to pitch in MLB 15.
Okay, my autosave's not even supposed to be on. Oh, I love how every time I turn this on, it just starts playing by new rules. That's awesome. Whatever. Let's see what's up in recruiting. Obviously, this team got a little ambitious with the schedule after winning the national title. They took their lumps this year. 3 losses already. I have to regroup. Okay, added a few guys to this board. We got a couple soft commits here. These guys all. This is a good recruiting class already. The high 70s, low 80s. These guys. Alright, what do we got? I think we had a lot of guys that had visits. Let's just get on the recruiting grind here. Greedy and sway him off an average. Oh, we got him up to average on that one. Obviously, we could use help on defense everywhere. And I thought we were pretty, you know, numbers wise, ratings wise, we are pretty good on defense. But.
We already have a good quarterback recruit coming in, but why not have two, right? We're still taking Sparty down. Beat him in the national title game. Try to beat him in recruiting here, although Virginia Tech's second on this guy's list. Kind of from very low to low. What about on this one? Very low to low. Low to average. I can sway this guy pretty well.
Dwayne Robinson.
He's already a soft commit. Let's get him to go all the way here.
Carl McMillan, the athlete.
Knocking Iowa down out of the race, hopefully. Big points on this guy. Ooh. Georgia Tech taking it hard here.
Got him up to average on that one. Average on that one. Oh, I haven't even offered this guy a scholarship. Probably should do that. Did I make him the promise? This is I figure I can do this one to everybody now. Good national exposure. I can't offer them to be starters anymore because these guys just don't come in and turn out to be starters anymore. Back in the early days, it was easy to offer anybody that was good a starting spot. We had to improve everywhere. We haven't offered him a scholarship yet either. Western Kentucky, come on, man. You want to go to UMass? You know you do. Put us number one. This guy hasn't been offered a scholarship. Or probably made the good exposure. There you go. You can tell these guys I've added relatively recently to the board. Because I haven't hit those things that I normally hit right away. I don't know why I just tried to sway a high importance, but... I did. Come on, Chuck, make the right choice. Okay, after that, these guys are all kind of marginal for my needs, but what do I got left? I got scouting time. This dude's a bust. Out this guy up. Bruce Jordan, athletes take forever to scout. Because they could potentially, you know, you don't know. They could potentially be at any position. It's for you to figure out where they fit best later. Get in here and get some points on them. Boy, we're trying to steal a bunch of people from Western Kentucky, apparently. Not sure why we're messing up this guy, but I guess you never know. Let's see where his scout's at. Anything moving upward? Oh yeah, he went plus four. That's not bad, actually. For somebody we're just discovering now. What do I got left? Scout the strong safety up, see what's up.
I think he's going to drop. Well, his jumping's up. Strength is down, injury's up. Eh. And we haven't scouted this guy either, but
let's at least go talk to him here.
Wait, did I skip? Oh, I skipped this guy because he's a bust. Eh, I'll keep him around on the board, I guess, for now. But that'll wrap up recruiting. We'll go ahead and sim the week forward. See how far we dropped. I would guess out of the top 10. Missouri next week. See if we get anyone to commit.
I'm kind of like, let's just get to our bowl game and move forward here with the new recruiting class, but whatever.
This is boring. Well, nobody's making you stay. It's kind of part of the dynasty, you know, working on your recruits. Yeah, Zachary, that's exactly it. But I was excited at first when they said they revamped the recruiting until I actually played it, and I'm like, I want NCAA 13's recruiting back. I loathe the 14 system. It seems so bad to me. Preparing those studio updates. All right, we got two. A 5-star and a 4-star. Sweet. Oh, we dropped all the way to 20. Oh, boy. Michigan State is your number one. Still. 1 and 2 stayed the same. Clemson went up one. Michigan's up a couple. Georgia took our number 5 slot. Holy cow. Seriously, my daughter, like,
she gets excited once in a while, but she is wound up out there. My goodness. She's talking like a crazy person. All the way down to 20. That's a tough fall right there. Just above Florida, who we absolutely destroyed. I want to see what those two were rated that committed.
We got 13 scholarships left. We got visits coming up. I'll worry about those later. So we got 13 scholarships left in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 11. We're still pursuing. All I see, this guy's soft for Western Kentucky. We won't give up on him yet, but we're probably not going to get him. Okay, so McMillan was the 74 overall athlete, and Bird was the 76 DN. Nice. Nice. Okay. Sweet. Pretty solid class so far. We got 11 guys, maybe 10 that we go after here. We'll probably lose this guy. Yeah, we'll see how that plays out. Anyway, and more autosave. I always tell it not to autosave, just in case something screws up.
Okay, well, disappointing lost, but disappointing loss, not lost.
Yeah.
But that's where we're going to end it for now. UMass takes a big step back to number 20. Still hoping for a New Year's Day Bowl, but they, I don't think, are going to be in on the BCS fun, or not playing for a national title, at least now with three losses. So that's that. But yeah,
thanks for joining me, guys, and we will see you soon.